was void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while the wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, let there be light. And there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And God said, let there be a dome in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters. So God made the dome and separated the waters that were under the dome from the waters that were above the dome. And it was so. God called the dome the sky. And there was evening and there was morning the second day. And God said, let the waters under the sky be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear. And it was so. God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together he called seas. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let the earth put forth vegetation, plants yielding seed, and fruit trees of every kind on the earth that bear fruit with the seed in it. And it was so. The earth brought forth vegetation, plants yielding seed of every kind, and trees of every kind bearing fruit with the seed in it. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the third day. And God said, let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate the day from the night. And let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and years. And let there be lights in the dome of the sky to give light on the earth. And it was so. God made the two great lights, the greater light to rule the day and the lesser light to rule the night and the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to give light on the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fourth day. And God said, let the waters bring forth swarms of living creatures, and let the birds fly above the earth across the dome of the sky. So God created the great sea monsters and every living creature that moves of every kind with which the waters swarm, and every winged bird of every kind. And God saw that it was good. God blessed them, saying, be fruitful and multiply and fill the waters and the seas, and let the birds multiply on the earth. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fifth day. And God said, let the earth bring forth living creatures of every kind, cattle and creeping things and wild animals of the earth of every kind. And it was so. God made the wild animals of the earth of every kind, the cattle of every kind, and everything that creeps upon the ground of every kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let us make humankind in our image, according to our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the wild animals of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth. So God created humankind in his image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, and God said to them, be fruitful and multiply and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the birds of the air and over every living thing that moves upon the earth. God said, see, I have given you every plant yielding seed that is upon the face of the earth, and every tree with seed in its fruit. You shall have them for food. And to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth, everything that has the breath of life, I have given every green plant for food. And it was so. God saw everything that he had made, and indeed it was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all their multitude. And on the seventh day, God finished the work that he had done. And he rested on the seventh day.
Thank you for standing. You may be seated. This can just very well be the very best day of my life. I'm so excited. I'm so
My name is Intern Professor Pastor K. K? Got that? K? Intern Professor Pastor K. K?
Molecular structures. Can you say that, fellow scientists? Molecular structures. This is just great. This all the things that are in the laboratory for SunSparks Lab. And are you excited?
Yeah. Professor, looks like you've been all meeting.
gravity verification sphere is a finely tuned instrument. It will show beyond a shadow of a doubt whether gravity is working. So, I'd like to call my lab assistant Faith to come up and help us with this experiment today. Let's give a round of applause for Faith.
Thank you.
hard that you can't move. Thank you.
That you've created each one of us. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, well, intern professor Pastor Kay has been is taking a nap now. He's really tired. So you guys go back, and you'll be getting a meeting tomorrow. Let's stand and with the whole church, let us confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified by the Holy Spirit. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again, he ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
And if you'll pray with me once again.
Holy friend, for that small community that we call our family with its strengths that nurture us, even its faults that inhibit its unity, we ask today for a special blessing. And for the family called the church, with its many loves and its numerous failures, we pray for your blessing, Lord, in your mercy. Gracious God, for that community we call our circle of friends, with its times of harmony and mutual joy and its sometimes incidents of misunderstanding or even neglect, we ask for your blessing. And for those communities that we call schools and universities where much knowledge is imparted, we ask your blessing as well, Lord, in your mercy. God, we thank you for sending your true child, Jesus, to reconcile us and all things. By your Holy Spirit, we pray that you would inspire all people of faith to goodwill and to strive untiringly for that place where the gifts and successes of each person are celebrated. We pray that today you would bring comfort, your grace and your mercy to the sick, to the dying, to the bereaved, especially all those that have requested our prayers this day. We remember before your throne of grace, Mildred Grove, Karen Spencer, Kari Ingebrigts, and Brad Manson, Ronnie Erickson, John Peterson, Beatrice Nerrison, Michael and Betty Darrington, Deborah Nalo, Jack Flayton, Tom Beals, Lauren Thome, Jen Holstrom, Vicki Swenson, Bev Stratmore, and Alyssa Beckman, and others that we name now before you in the silence of our hearts. In God of unspeakable love, if you can use us to answer any of these prayers or the prayers of our fellow Christians around the world, we pray that you would take us and guide us and employ us to the glory of your holy name. We pray for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Savior and our Lord. Amen.